And here's the introduction. And how's that for a roll? Australia.
Well, and Lossie's here, I think.
Look on the left, Janelle Elford. She's there. She's in green. And here's Lisa Carey, this great supermum for Australia, followed by her Australian teammates. Behind Lisa, we see the team management, the officials, and there's the Australian flag made by the choir under the scoreboard in the women's ranks. We have Olympia champion Debbie Flintoff-King. Janelle Elford, not Lisa Carey. Lisa Martin, the marathon winner. World champion walker Kerry Saxville. A lot of potential gold medalists. And here's the Duke, or rather the Prince, who's going to wave to the Australian team.
Oh, well, Lisa Carey there, when she's lowered the flag, but I just wonder what Lisa Carey is thinking right now. It has to be one of the proudest moments for Lisa. She's got 3 gold medals, she's got a beautiful daughter and a handsome husband, but now she's leading the Australian team. How do you feel, Lisa? And how heavy is that flag, Lisa?
It's very hard to hear. The crowd is making so much noise. But I can say that the Australian team behind me, just to be here wearing green and gold, must be one of the proudest moments of their lives. It's fantastic.
We'll talk to you again in a moment. We'll just let you sit down. Let's look at some of the other Australian athletes, Norman.
And look at these Australian uniforms. The men's ranks, we have a great team here. We have people like Robert Di Castella, Steve Montaghetti in the marathon, and we're looking now at the women's team. Let's see if we can pick up someone out. We've got some great talent here. Youngsters like Hayley Lewis in swimming, April Adams in diving. She's a Maori supporter as this great Australian team comes down. I think they can break all records as far as gold medals are concerned. They're jumping out of their skin. I've never seen a team looking so ready for it. And I've been to plenty of games, but this team is a good one. And I also detect a very strong feeling of intense personal pride about representing their country.
Certainly, Norman, besides all those reports you've had about morale being a problem, there's been no morale problem as far as I'm concerned across the village or talking to anyone else. They really are out to win this one.
Now there's Robert Di Castella. He's there. What a wonderful moment for him, you know, that he's going for his 3rd marathon in these games. No other person in history has ever won the Commonwealth Marathon twice. I see the crew cut of the cyclist.